the Stanley Cup. For over a century, bearing the names of hockey's best. To hold it, you need strength to raise 30 pounds of stainless steel. A high pain threshold helps. Shaking off collisions helps. Strong will helps. Day and night commitment to one goal is essential. To hold it, you need offensive players who can change the course of a game with one lightning strike. Their experience helps. Their confidence is essential. To hold it, you also need the important countering defensive players. To hold it, you need a goalie who can keep the 5 ounces of rubber out of a 4-by-6-foot net. Will this captain be next to hold it? Or this one? Or some other? The first in a series is coming up. Devils in Boston on Fox.
Stanley Cup in 1972. Their quest to end three decades of frustration begins tonight. For the Devils, success has been more recent, but a near miss in 2001 and an early exit last year has made this team more determined to return to glory. Tonight it's game one, the first step along what both teams hope will be a long road as they square off in the Eastern Conference quarterfinals here at the Continental Airlines Arena. Hi, everybody. I'm Matt Lachlan. Thanks for joining us. Even though the regular season only ended on Sunday, for these teams now it's a distant memory. The focus is on what takes place from tonight throughout what they hope is a trip to the Stanley Cup Finals. For more on game one of this battle between Boston and the Devils, let's send it upstairs to Doc and Chico.
Matt, thanks, everyone. Welcome to the Stanley Cup playoffs here on Fox. We have a lot of Devils action to bring you. The Devils are hoping to win 16 games over 8 weeks' time. It will be a great time. Their challenge is formidable here when it comes to defense against offense, because when you look at this front line, the top line for the Boston Bruins, you see 45% of the goals the Bruins scored this year are by Knubel, Thornton, and Murray.
110 goals, Doc. This big line just has been rumbling through opposition defenses. I asked Marty Brodeur about him, and he said, well, first of all, Joe Thornton is a fabulous passer and playmaker. And he says those other two guys, Glenn Murray and Knubel, always seem to have their sticks up in the air whenever they're in the zone, ready to one-time it. And there you see that happening with Glenn Murray. Now, individually, Joe Thornton, he could take the puck to the net on his own, and that was just a brilliant move as he beat four Devils defense. Here, right off the face-off, that right-handed shooting, Mike Knubel, a career year for him. He hammers one home. So this line, Doc, I don't know. It's so dangerous. I don't know, as Pat Byrne says, if they could be stopped completely. Devils are just going to try and minimize them.
Sergei Samsonov returned the final game of the regular season, so he adds even more depth to the Bruins at forward. But what about the defense? Well, it's been the prime thing for the Devils this year. Look at the league leaderships. In the penalty kill, they were best. Shots against average, they were best, limiting teams to only 23.5 a game. Even though they tied with Philadelphia in the last two categories, they played 4 minutes more, so technically they were first there too.
Well, when you talk about this series and the one edge the Devils have, everyone points to team defense, and they love to play it. Look at down low here. That's the first area you want to take care of. The other thing, you want to eliminate point shots. Great play by Jay Pandolfo and all the Devils winger. Again, down low, Devils double team to take away dangerous shot. And look at the back checking. That's the other thing the Devils do so well. And then when it does break down, they break up breakdowns better than any other team. That time it was Stevens on a two-on-one. That time it's Scotty Niedermeyer. So the Devils in very good shape in their own end.
Well, at playoff time, we always look to that last line of defense. They are the guys who are going to make the biggest difference in their teams. And we have two here that faced one another last Thursday. Steve Shields and Martin Brodeur. And last Thursday, it was a tie. We don't get ties in the playoffs.
Well, goaltending is so much about confidence. And it was a week ago that Steve Shields came in this building and played the Devils. And he was outstanding, Doc. The Devils had at least 15 scoring quality chances. And he rose to the occasion in the 1-1 tie, especially in overtime where the pressure was on. Here you're going to see two of his best by Brian Rafalski. But talking to the Bruins today, that was a big confidence builder for him. And Marty Brodeur, it's been all season long, a fabulous season for Marty Brodeur. He was forceful, he was in control in the driver's seat, and he was brilliant from beginning to end. And of course, it always comes down to the goaltenders, and this series will be no different.
What do we watch for at the start of the game?
Well, I don't know exactly, Doc. I think both teams would like to minimize the mistakes early on. Of course, you don't want to get in a hole. Devils a very confident team. I think they have the edge mentally coming in, but the Bruins, they're looking for something good to happen in the first period and start really believing that they can beat this Devils team. So the first period, like the first game, very important as we get started tonight.
It will be great fun. So let's have at it. We'll be back with the face-off for round one, game one. Bruins and the Devils. And tonight, it is Steve Shields against the Devils' Martin Brodeur. After these words.